You know, Kate's in the building because the smell of delicious cooking goes wafting through the building, and then it's like they're floating on air. They're like that cartoon, and they just glide right into the kitchen. Now, what you're going to be making today, this is something that everybody should know how to make, because as we were talking about off camera, I learned how to make this in home ec class.
Yeah, eighth grade. Mrs. Talbert taught us thank you. Taught me how to make ham fried rice. You know, by the time
basics.
Before we could even like make it, we'd eaten like half the ham or whatever. Mm-hmm. But this is such an easy recipe, but I cannot believe how many people don't know how to make this.
Okay, my first question I wanted to ask is about the rice. Is it better to use freshly cooked pot of rice or a day old pot of rice?
That is, I think, a personal preference, because so many people say, oh, you gotta have day old rice, so that is the trick.
Yeah.
But for me, I'm doing
rice
it the same. Yeah, I'm doing it the same day. My rice cooker makes it a little crumbly, so it is as though it, you know, maybe is the day old. Sticky rice, you're not gonna have a great product with that.
Now, you had mentioned a little bit that your ham is a little different.
Of course.
That you've smoked it.
Obviously. Yeah.
When it comes to Kate, you know she's going to smoke her meat.
I'm smoking my meat. Yeah. Yes, of course. I like a bone-in, non-spiral sliced butt ham, and I throw it on my smoker to give it.
Because we like big butts. Yes. We cannot lie.
Yeah. Bum, bum, bum. And I will use that because I want that extra layer of flavor. So what is the key ingredient with ham fried rice, though? Sesame oil.
Okay.
You have to use sesame oil. If you are just going to use canola or vegetable or olive oil, you're missing out on
it. There's a blandness to it, and you might have to add more salt or pepper because there's not a lot of flavor.
Absolutely. Well, as you're talking, it smells so good in here. We're smelling that sesame oil.
My salivary glands are highly
active
right now.
They're dying. Yes. So what we've done is we've sauteed up this ham in that sesame oil. We want it to get a little brown on all of those edges. We're throwing in our carrots. We want them to soften up a bit. And that doesn't take very long. And then give it a little space. We're throwing in our eggs. Scramble those guys up.
You put a number of eggs in there. Do you try to measure it according to how big the whole batch is going to be?
For sure. Like for me, with the 8 cups of rice I'm going to be putting in here, I'm throwing in 6 eggs.
Okay.
I like more of the stuff versus the rice. So I'm like, give me more of like the ham and the eggs and all of that. Because I want it like 50-50.
Yeah.
I don't want like a lot of rice and
not a lot
piece
of,
of ham here or there.
You don't want to go diving for your ham.
Exactly. Yeah. So I'm all about like a lot of substance in my ham fried rice. And I love making this in like triple, double, quadruple batches because my kids will eat this for breakfast.
Yeah, really quick, I don't want to run out of time before mentioning that I like to use Spam. We only started using ham when it was left over.
Yeah,
so it wouldn't go to waste.
Growing up, it was Spam fried rice for me, and I absolutely love it. But it was ham fried rice when we had leftover ham.
Yeah.
So use what you like and make it work.
Now, are you trying to cook the eggs all the way through before adding the rice in?
Just about the hot rice, or it's going to continue to cook that up as well.
Okay.
So we're going to add in a bunch of rice. Go ahead and stir that, Buddha.
Okay.
I'm making a mess, but that's what we do, and that's all right. In home ec, we were taught to throw the green onions in and saute them up, but I like to throw them in at the end because they're going to have more flavor, be a little more potent. So we're gonna soy sauce it until the color is where you want it. You're gonna throw about 3 tablespoons of soy sauce
Now, to fast forward it, Kate made an entire bowl already. What I love about it is that you don't have to think about a side dish. It is a complete meal
in one
bowl.
You've got your eggs, your
veggies. Always bring such great things for us. And again, I love your recipes because your recipes make me look like a pro in the kitchen. If you wanna follow Kate and learn more tips, how do we do so?
Find me on Facebook and on Instagram, even my website, katesmeatsandmills.com, on Facebook, Instagram,
As we say in Hawaii, broke the mouth. That means it's really, really
good.
Broke the mouth. Fox13now.com, click on the place.